Good day, everyone. Ali Safi here from Safi Financial Network. Today is July 3rd, 2024. Here is another daily analysis. All right, let's just start with S&P 500 daily chart. So today, market just broken up nicely to the upside. Fantastic breakout. This is a bullish consolidation as we expected. Market just went to the another rally phase after this digestive move within time. And this is consolidation that we were waiting for to break out. And yesterday, I just posted that a 55.60 S&P is coming down the road, which I believe it's going to happen potentially next 2-3 days if market just give us a boost another time. Tomorrow, market will be closed at July 4th. I believe Friday, we can see another session to the upside. Today, market was half session, so it's kind of like very, very light volume, but market just had a very nice optimism always. And in the first 2 weeks of July, we will have the best period of the year. So we can see some kind of like another bullish momentum to the upside. The potential bias within the next 2 weeks, we can get even to 5,600, which I believe it's going to be very, very important level for the top. So if you see market is getting to this area, I should say by... this area to July, let's say July 19, we can see the top in the market. So it is gonna be a favorite zone for a topping formation. And after that, I should say everyone needs to be careful. Right now, we are just seeing a bullish consolidation breakout, and this is gonna be the last phase of this good momentum. After that, we should expect a sharp sell-off to the downside. So what do I mean by sharp sell-off? We will see that, let's say, July 15 afterwards. We need to be prepared for a sharp sell-off. Right now, we will have 2 weeks. Enjoy this 2 weeks rally, short-term rally. But this is kind of like a weekly top. And this weekly top can end up to the weekly bottom, which weekly bottom can give us very, very low price for S&P 500. Moving on to NASDAQ, which was kind of like a booster for today. Almost 184 points to the upside. NASDAQ is getting into this important area. So this bull flag trigger to the upside, nicely new all-time high. 20,182 is here. So NASDAQ is getting into new all-time high today. And we should see the same scenario for NASDAQ as well. So if market goes up for the next 2-3 weeks, I should say next 2 weeks, then we can see kind of like a top information for a nice sharp sell-off to the downside. And that would be kind of like the scenario that I'm just looking at. Moving on to US 30, which is Dow. Let me just go to Dow. Here's the Dow Jones. So Dow is kind of like a forming a bullish consolidation. Even today was negative. Interesting. So it's just barely negative, but it didn't follow NASDAQ properly. So Dow is just forming a nice bullish consolidation. We can see starting next week, Dow is going to outperform as well. So we can see all three indexes by next 2 weeks, all at new all-time high. Then the rollover or sharp sell-off is going to happen after July 15, July 17. Moving on to gold, which had a nice move to the upside. Gold is just spiking up today, 1.13% to the upside. And the good thing is gold miners, silver, all did the same thing. So gold is just breaking out nicely. And also anyway, if you want to just put it this way, if we get above a 2390, then I should say 2417. And also, I'm just looking for a potential new all-time high for gold. So 2500, 2490, that's going to be on the table around the corner for the next 2 weeks. Then like the other market, we should see some kind of like a sell-off after that. Moving on to silver, which had nice move to the upside. So silver, as I mentioned before, silver is just forming a bottom here. So this is a nice W pattern within this bull flag. I believe that the best case scenario is going to be silver just spiking up to 34 to 34.90, which is $35 per ounce. The smaller target is going to be here, which is going to be double top or stretching above and then coming back down. So there should be kind of like a divergence between these two. And then we can see the pullback or a sharp sell-off after that. So that's kind of like the scenario that I'm just looking at for precious metals and the stock market as well. But silver basically just nailed down our analysis. Crude had a positive day today, forming kind of like a nice bullish consolidation. I believe that crude is topped, folks. And any rally could be a sell, even it can go higher. But I believe that the sell-off is going to be very, very sharp, and drop can retest this bottom or even lower, going down to test these bottoms here. So that's why I sold out all my energy positions yesterday as well. And moving on to individual names, starting with Bitcoin. Bitcoin sharp sell-off today. Bitcoin, all cryptos actually went down today. Bitcoin, this breakout, I believe, happened. And we can see some kind of like a nice sell-off all the way to 48 to 52,000. So this is the scenario that we were waiting for. And I was bullish until like a breakout, but we didn't have a breakout. So this scenario is over. Now we kind of like lost this pivot here. And the only pivot is going to be 56,000. So 60,000 can go down all the way to 48,000 to 52,000. Moving on to Ethereum. Ethereum down today. So Ethereum goes down sharply as well with Bitcoin, 4.858% to the downside. Bond yield is down today as well. So bond yield is forming a bearish consolidation. Seems like rate is going to go down. A dollar is going to go down as well. So that's why TLT just spiked up today. After a sharp sell-off last 2-3 days, TLT just regaining $90. So this is very, very important. We need to recapture this pivot going all the way up to 95 to 97. VIX $6.06 up today with a sharp move to the upside in the all-time high. VIX just holding up pretty well. So this means VIX is forming the bottom. Dixie downtick today, very sharp sell-off, just the retesting this dynamic trend line here. And it can go below 105 and even below this pivot. If it goes below this pivot, 104, then it can go 101 to 102. Moving on to Magma indicator, which is here. So Magma, new all-time high today. No, actually, just the uptick, nothing, new all-time high. Apple, new all-time high today. Fantastic move. $1.28, $22.55. Amazon, $2.41 down today. Amazon didn't follow the market. Meta went up, 46 cents up. Microsoft, $1.49 up. Google, 58 cents up. New all-time high for Google. Netflix, $2.93 up. Still forming a bullish consolidation. Tesla, fantastic surge, ripping up to the upside, 6.54%. So Tesla, very, very soon, we just see Tesla just ripping nicely. And this trend line, this major trend line, broken nicely. So as I said yesterday, this is very, very important. When we see this trend line broken, potentially we will see a back test for a nice rally to the upside. So if you were here in our channel, we were looking for Tesla to get into 250, 260. Sure enough, even after hours, Tesla just traded 248. Fantastic, fantastic move. Last 3 days, Tesla just unbelievable, going higher nicely. Moving on to SMH, which is semiconductor index, going up today as well. $6 up, 2.27% up. Stocks $4.17 up. Good pattern here. Taiwan Semiconductor, nice surge, gapped up. And then continuing all the way up to the upside. AMD, just after yesterday's surge, just hiccup today. I believe AMD is going to follow up the market as well. NVIDIA, fantastic move, 4.57% up. Pretty good surge, NVIDIA. NVIDIA can go 130 to 132, but after that, I'm not sure. Texas Instruments, 52 cents up today. And Lam Research, $9.92. up today as well. Moving on to bank. Bank just didn't follow the market, going down 13 cents. KBE, 63 cents down. KRE, 80 cents down. You know, after hours, it goes lower. 48.45, just the closing for today. JP Morgan, after hitting new all-time high. Today, just hit new all-time, new nominal all-time high, and then getting back down. So this is very, very important. Moving on to Goldman Sachs, $2.31 up today, kind of like a double top here. Bank of America, 33 cents down, new all-time high as well. Wells Fargo, 31 cents down. It's just a pullback after surge to the upside. Moving on to gold miners, which had a fantastic move to the upside, $1.26 up. Fantastic move. Gold miners, they just to start their rally to the upside. GDX, $1.86 up. AEM, $2.38 up. And Newmont, $1.74 up. Fantastic move for all of them. They just they went nicely. Franco-Nevada, great pattern here, just getting into important wide range bar. Rejected from the top, but again, look at these two rejection as well. So we just follow through with a nice bullish momentum to the upside. Gold Barrick moving up to the upside even after hours, it goes higher as well. So nice, a bull flag formed and triggered to the upside. Moving on to XLE, which is Energy Spider, just uptick today, but I believe that they are very weak. So even if there is a breakout, I don't think they're gonna break out nicely. So we will see how it goes. XOP, $1.24 up, still just in this triangle wedge pattern. OIH, oil and gas services, they broken up nicely, but they need to get above 324. Exxon, 58 cents up, and Chevron, 4 cents down today. So all of them are kind of like a mix, but I believe that they are not strong as they should be. Crude just went to the upside. They didn't even trigger a buy signal, breakout buy signal to the upside. So we will see how it goes. Again, tomorrow market will be closed. We will be back on Friday and hope you enjoy this interesting long weekend in US. Have a fantastic evening. See you on the chart. Bye-bye.